In this video, we're going to start to learn about improper integrals. Now, the object of the game is to try to make sense of expressions like the integral from 0 to infinity of e to the minus x dx. Now, we know what integrals are in general, areas under the curve or limits of sums. But the funny thing here is we're taking an integral out to infinity. And we don't know what that means yet. Now, we're also going to work that example. We're going to work this example, which is going to behave a little bit differently, even though at first glance it looks the same. You're integrating a function from a number up to infinity. These are called type 1 improper integrals. They're type 1 because they involve integrating a perfectly nice function all the way out to infinity. There's also what we call type 2. Type 2 is a not-so-nice function. This function blows up as x approaches 0, but we're going to see that we can make sense of the integral anyway. And finally, there are some functions where you could integrate out to infinity, or you can integrate from minus infinity, or you could do both. This is also type 1. So in this video, we're going to talk about type 1 improper integrals. In the next video, we'll talk about type 2. So let's review what an ordinary integral is. So an ordinary integral, we've got a nice function y, we've got a nice function f of x, and we want to integrate it from a to b. And the key idea is that integrals are limits of sums. So how do we deal with this? We break the interval from a to b into pieces. We pick a point in each piece. We compute a Riemann sum, and then we take a limit. So that's the definition of an integral. Now, that's a definition, but of course, it's good to visualize it with a picture. The standard example that can be solved with integrals is area under a curve, and we have our picture of chopping the interval from a to b into n pieces, and then f of x delta x is the area, approximate area of one of these strips. You add them up together and you get the total area. You take a limit, it becomes exact. Now, if we try to do that for an improper integral, we run into trouble. Because here we have the interval from a all the way out to infinity. The game is we want to figure out what is this total area under the curve to the right of x equals a. And there's just no way to break the interval from a to infinity into n equal pieces. It's infinitely big. So what we do instead is we pick a point out here. Let's call it t. And we say, let's figure out what is all of the area out to t. Well, we know how to do that. We just compute the integral from 0 to t. And then we compute the integral out to a bigger value of t, and a bigger value of t, and a bigger value of t. And we take a limit as t goes to infinity. So the definition of an integral from 0 to infinity is you do the integral from 0 to t, and then take a limit as t goes to infinity. So let's do an example. So we want to find the area between the x-axis, the y-axis, and the curve y equals e to the minus x. Okay, so the first step is we figure out the area out to t. The area out to t is just the integral from 0 to t. The integral from 0 to t of e to the minus x dx. We can do that with the fundamental theorem of calculus. The antiderivative of e to the minus x is minus e to the minus x. Plug it in at t and at 0. And you get 1 minus e to the minus t. Great. So now we take a limit. The integral from 0 to infinity is the limit of this expression as t gets bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. When t is a giant number, e to the minus t is a tiny number. The limit of e to the minus t is 0. So we get 1 minus 0, and that's 1. And it's tempting to say, oh yeah, the answer is e to the minus x dx evaluated at 0 and at infinity, and e to the minus infinity is 0. Okay, if you understand that that's shorthand for the limit of e to the minus t is 0, great. But you should shy away from trying to plug in the value infinity because it really doesn't make sense. Infinity is a limit, not a number. You should think about what happens as you take a limit. So our terminology for this is if the limit exists, then we say that the integral converges. And whatever the limit is, well, that's what we say it converges to. So the integral from 0 to infinity of minus e to the minus x dx is 1, and we say it converges to 1. Now, at first glance, finding the area between x equals 1, the x-axis, and y equals 1 over x looks kind of the same. We want to figure out the integral from, we want to figure out the integral from 1 to infinity of 1 over x dx. So we take the integral from 1 to t of 1 over x dx, and that's easy. That's the natural log of t. And the integral from 1 to infinity is the limit of that. So that's the limit of the natural log. But as t gets bigger and bigger and bigger, the natural log gets bigger and bigger and bigger. This limit is infinity. There is no finite number. There's an infinite amount of area. And so when the limit doesn't exist, we say that the integral diverges. Okay, that's the terminology. Okay, a couple more problems. We're going to be very interested in which integrals converge and which integrals diverge. These are going to be the same kinds of questions that you're going to see a lot of when we do sequences and series. So let's get a warm-up by looking at this for integrals. So for what values of p does this integral converge? Well, we've got to take an integral from 1 to t. And how do you take, an integral of x to the minus p? You just get x to the 1 minus p divided by 1 minus p. Evaluate that at 1 and at t. And you get t to the 1 minus p minus 1 over 1 minus p. And we want to limit as t goes to infinity. Well, if p is less than 1, then this is a positive power of t. And the bigger t is, the bigger this is going to be. So if p is less than 1, this is going to blow up. If p is bigger than 1, this is a negative power of t, and it gets smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller. So if p is bigger than 1, this goes to 0, and you get negative 1 over 1 minus p, which is to say 1 over p minus 1. If p is less than 1, the whole thing diverges. And we've already done the case of p equals 1, the integral of 1 over x. So we can add that. Okay. Finally, I mentioned that you could have integrals with minus infinity. So those are integrals where you're going out infinitely far to the left. So instead of taking a limit as t goes to infinity, we start off at a point t, and we take the limit as t goes to minus infinity. In other words, we take a point way here to the left, t. We figure out what this area is. And then we push this point t leftwards. We take a limit as t goes to minus infinity, and that's what we mean. Okay? So for example, if you want the integral from minus infinity to 0 of e to the x dx, you take the integral from t to 0 of e to the x dx, which is just e to the x evaluated at 0 and in t. And you get 1 because as t goes to minus infinity, e to the t goes to 0. Okay. Finally, if you've got an integral from minus infinity to infinity, you have to split it into two integrals. You've got one term that involves a limit as t goes to minus infinity, another term that involves a limit as t goes to plus infinity. Do not do them together. That's it.